Ah, Davy.
This is it. Ah, the culmination of our toils and troubles. Aching backs and sore feet. It all comes down to this moment. I'm so excited I believe I have to pee a little bit.
Your insufficient bladder has been getting on my nerves.
What was that?
Ow. Nothing. Just, you should probably think twice before defecating on the Maker's tulip garden.
Oh dear! Oh, damn it, get stubborn with that started!
For the love of demonic possession, I'll just take care of this myself!
No, Davy! You can't go in alone!
Watch me, old man!
Davy?
Ah, Mortalitus, there you are. Finally someone knows my name. Well, of course I know your name, you're just a figment of my imagination. Oh, believe me. I'm realer than anything you've previously encountered! So, did you have fun getting here? I tried to make the journey as easy as possible for you, but you know how it is with conflict with writing, you just kind of need it.
Rumble, tumble, rumble, fumble! Oh, these boots are mighty unwieldy indoors!
Oh, George, there you are! I was just making some cookies, would you want some?
Yes! There is the master and commander of my existence. Oh, if I wasn't sure, I'd believe that my glass eye was playing tricks on me again, but... Oh. Davy, wait. Can he see us?
If I heard you correctly, did you say that you brought us here? Of course I did. How else would you have traversed four different worlds that are completely unconnected?
I never did quite figure that out myself.
But why? Well, I don't know. Just kind of bored this morning. And really, I kind of just wanted to break the fourth wall.
Hey, there you are.
I see you.
Look at me go!
My brilliance, who are you talking to?
Oh, that's right. You don't exist on my plane, so you can't see the cameras. I suppose it'd be pointless to tell you to wave.
Hello?
Enough! I have very low tolerance for impudence, even from the being that brought me into existence.
Oh dear.
If I can't hurt you, then I'll hurt the ones you love. Until you give me what I want. Clearly you like him more than me. He's a blubbering idiot and he still managed to become president!
Davy, why can't I move my arms? Please, don't high five my forehead. I don't think that would feel very good. Just put me down, please.
Alright, that's enough. Put George down.
No!
What?
I said no!
I wonder why you're not actually stopping. Maybe I have to actually write it down?
Or perhaps your imagination has gotten the best of you.
Oh dear, well, what is it that you want?
I want you, or the power that you wield. With it, I will be the creator, and all will bow to my will.
Well, no, it doesn't work like that. I don't know of anyone who's actually brought a fictional character into reality before.
Well, perhaps this will spur you into action.
No! Oh god, how could this be happening?
Give me your power, Jack!
You just killed off your leverage very quickly. I thought I wrote you smarter than that.
It's the monologues. That must be why you made me British.
Oh, he's still going on with that, huh?
It appears so. Usually when I do this, they just evaporate into thin air.
I will not die.
Well, you definitely should die. The oven! Wait! Would you let your precious George Washington die so easily?
Take me, Jack. I don't think I'm gonna come back this time.
I'm sorry, George. When it comes down to it, this is a decision over what's imaginary and what is real.
Always burned so easily! Now my book club party is completely ruined!
Defeat tastes quite bitter, or shall I say, burnt, does it not?
Indeed it does.
But I wouldn't know personally, Mortalitus. You see, there's one thing about old George that you don't know.
What could there possibly be? He's such a simple creature.
That's something you should know about me by now, Mortalitus. I never create one-dimensional characters. Oh, and look at that. A full moon.
Nobody gets between me and my...
Oh, God! Okay, sit back! Sit back, I'll banish you to the demons! Oh, God!
Okay, stay back!
Okay, I'm okay.
Who would have thought that he was a werewolf? I haven't encountered one of those in over 1,000 years. That's the benefit of being the master of all creation. Anything's possible, Mortalitus.
As much as I admire your ambition, I believe I proved you wrong just a moment ago.
But now you're weakened, and I know exactly what to do with you.
I know no fear. Banish me to the sacred realm. Lock me away for eternity. I don't care. I'll survive. I always survive! Do your worst, Jack Dalton!
Oh, I shall. But it won't have anything to do with the conservative storyline, no. I have something much more agonizing in mind for you.
No!
Well, hello!
Not him! Anything but that fiend!
You are one of the most threatening characters I ever created, Mortalitus. Now the only way to destroy you is by trapping you in one of the most pathetic characters I've ever created.
No! I refuse to be held captive by the satanic housekeeper! What a lovely house you have! But he's so weak!
Oh, that's where you're wrong. His feebleness is his power!
I have powers!
He shall not defeat me!
I like winning games!
No!
Yes!
Release me!
New friends!
My precious freedom!
Precious!
Mr. Stevenson, congratulations. Now you will always have a dinner guest.
Hooray!
No!
George.
Oh.
But I always had faith that you would survive.
You had faith in old George? What, the creator?
George, please stop calling me that. I'm Catholic.
Oh. Sorry. I'm just so perplexed as to why you would have faith in old George.
Of course I believed in you, George. You're part of my imagination. In some vague, detached, unrelated, inexplicable, and nothing like me at all way. You are me. Come now, George, don't get all sappy on me.
I'm sorry.
Oh my God, okay.
George, save the sap for the trees.
Okay, no, that's not what I meant.
Well, now that this is all over,
uh-huh.
What's next? Now that we've met, what's next for me?
Well, that's why I invited you here.
What is this offering?
It's for you. No longer shall I impose my desires on your life, George. From this moment on, you write your own destiny.
But, I'm illiterate.
Are you fucking kidding
me? You hit me once, I hit you back. You gave a kick, I gave a